Dear Ajahn, during the meditation session last night, I felt that it was more serene and stable than any other I have had before. Throughout the 40-minute session, I could hold my awareness on the breath, even if I did some contemplation, the breath still seemed very clear and present in the background. Fascinated, I tried to induce some conditions to invoke the hindrances. That's interesting. If any, such as remembering the betrayal of a friend. Yet even so, the peace did not wane, and it was as if the anger from the past was pacified, like someone throwing a burning arrow into a solid wall of water. There wasn't any heightened joy, like how I've heard people experience when they are in sublime peace. Mine was just steady, peaceful, and stable. Am I doing this right? So that kind of peacefulness, as I understand it, is actually superior to joy. So what we're describing as steady, peaceful and stable and cool. So when the Lord Buddha says peacefulness is the highest happiness. And it's almost as if you have to become attenuated to it or acquire a taste for it because it's so new. But what happens is if you can have peacefulness like that a few times, you kind of get that that's definitely better than anything else I've had so far in terms of pleasure. But it's not joy. Joy is in a way it's a reaction. Happiness, saying that we want happiness, and we want sadness, we're so used to grasping. But this is superior. Steady, stable, cool serenity is superior to joy in terms of its wholesomeness. And it has arisen because mindfulness has been sustained consistently. And this is how Ajahn Achalo teaches us to develop samadhi, is consistent mindfulness. Then what arises is samma samadhi, right collectedness. And in this state is equanimity. So samadhi has a certain amount of equanimity. And as if people train in jhanas, I think fourth jhana is pure equanimity, but there's some equanimity there. And it gets more and more solid, more and more immovable, more and more cool if we train in samadhi. As my teachers have explained. So I wouldn't recommend trying to test it though by bringing up an old grievance. I mean, in terms of someone who's interested in understanding how the mind works and okay, there's time and place for experimenting, and it's good, in this case it's good that you didn't inflame the old grievance. But basically when peacefulness arises like that, it's best to stay with it and allow it to become as deep as possible and just stay, because when you look back on your life so far, this is the most peaceful it's ever been, so you don't want to kind of quickly destroy that. It's something to enjoy and learn from, because this is the potential of being a conscious being. Is that this is what we were talking about yesterday, about your inheritance, having practiced a lot of dharma, a lot of sila, having a human birth, encouraging people to have a look at their inheritance, what's in there, if you really turn inwards and have a look. So that kind of stable, cool, serene peace is probably the jhana samadhi, so that's what they call touching on apana, absorption. And what Ajahn Anand says is to stay with that, and what you'll find is the mind will become full to the extent that it can of peacefulness, and then it will move from the peacefulness itself, so you don't need to worry that you'll get lost in the peace at this stage. Apparently if you develop it further and further, you can get lost in the peace, but you still don't die. You just have to be born as a Brahmadeva. None of us are at that. That's not a danger for us yet. It's really good to experience the potential of being conscious. You know, having been alive is this kind of serenity, this kind of peace. And also good to understand that in terms of samadhi, that's kind of the beginning. You know, what I mean by that is it gets better and better and better. And so Ajahn Achalo says about human beings and meditators, he says, because of our accumulated merits, we have this mansion, and we don't know most of the beautiful rooms in the mansion. We spend our time hanging out in a couple of cramped, dusty rooms, mulling over the same old files. But you actually have this mansion there. And so this is like the beginning to get to know. He says Upajara Samadhi is like coming inside from a hot, sunny path and being in a cool on the inside. So it's a good experience, but what I can stress is that the mind will move from that state naturally. You don't need to test it or do anything, you just allow it to deepen. And when it comes out, you pick up a skillful contemplation. Because what you did was actually dangerous, bringing up the old grievance, because if mindfulness wasn't good, what's happening when the mind has some samadhi is it's got more energy than normal. And so if you bring up an unskillful contemplation, all of that energy can go into it, and you can end up hating the friend that betrayed you more than ever before. So it's really dangerous. And it's actually good that samadhi develops slowly and that mindfulness develops slowly with it, because you need to be responsible with it. It's similar if you're getting this, the most collected, most peaceful your mind has ever been, and then if you go into lust, it's the same thing. You could become a very scary person. So it's not yet the time to test the stability of your samadhi if you get some. It's the time to be aware of it, appreciate it, understand your potential to feel peaceful. And then when you come out of, when the mind moves from that state, then you get to work investigating your three characteristics. Anicca, dukkha, anatta, however you're interested. Cessation of each breath, the way you're feeling. So this is the thing about having that equanimity, is that if you come out of that and you've still got some of the equanimity, you can have a really good look at knee pain without moving. And you might have that experience of being able to separate the awareness from the pain. And you can have quite a bit of, you know, develop insight about the fact that I'm usually identified with pain. I think it's me, it's my knee pain, but look what happens when it's in samadhi. It's just pain, it's not self. And this is very valuable. So you can test your samadhi, but usually what's taught is to test it within the parameters of the body. So test it with pain, physical pain. Very good.